what started out as a typical bridge replacement for the Virginia Department of Transportation has become a fascinating historical discovery. On this hill above the Potomac River in Westmoreland County, archaeologists from the College of William & Mary, working on behalf of VDOT, encountered oyster mittens, something like ancient trash heaps of discarded shells. Pottery found in the area indicates the site was used during the mid-Woodland period, about 1,500 years ago.
This seems to be a place where a small group of people, Native Americans, would come probably seasonally, returning year after year or every few years to harvest oysters out of the Potomac River.
What was not found at the site offers as many clues to its use as what was discovered. The fact that no fish bones or crab remains were found indicates the site was probably used during the late winter or early spring. The oysters are believed to have supplemented a food supply that had dwindled over the winter. Some of the artifacts found at the site may have been tools used to pry open shells. In addition to telling us something about the Native Americans of 1,500 years ago, the site has also shed some light on the Chesapeake Bay and its changing ecology.
When people talk about restoring the health of the bay, what does that mean exactly? You need some baseline for understanding what you're restoring it to.
These oyster shells give scientists a window into a healthy bay long before European colonization. It is believed that oyster beds were visible from the Potomac shoreline and easily accessible to Native Americans who would wade or paddle canoes out to harvest them. This discovery reminds us just how long people have enjoyed the bounty of Virginia's waters. Who would have known this bridge crossing a creek into Colonial Beach would become an archaeological discovery that spans centuries?